many girls they blacked up. I see you leaving. Diddy bopping. Let's get it popping. I said let's get it popping. Just look at how she dropping. My mama certified pro. She need her own show.
Welcome. We are going to be doing a strength workout today. So it's going to be about 50 minutes. Just grab some weights. And if you have a yoga block or a book and you want to use that just for like one or two exercises, it's really not necessary. So weights are the most important things. Whatever you have around your house, grab that. Light to medium, medium to heavy. That's perfect. Put some music on. My music's being a little bit funky today. And I also, sometimes it gets blocked if the music's too loud. So put some energetic music on. You want to get yourself all ready, fired up for this workout. Again, about 50 minutes, okay? So we're going to get started in 30 seconds. Where's my yoga block?
Good. Out and in. Step touch.
more comfortable. Go for four. Two more here. Hold it down, pulse it. In four, three, two, hands to the floor. Take a little stretch. Bend those knees. Good, press the hips back up, straighten the legs. Bend it down. Press up and straighten, good. Inhale. Exhale, remember to use that breath today, guys. Two more. Last one. Good, hold it there, slowly roll it on up. Feet go hip distance. Change from the hips, take it down. Bring it up and squeeze those glutes. Hips go back. Good, so this is your prep for any type of deadlift, hip hinge movement. So I can really focus, sending the hips back, letting the upper body just come along. Exhale, inhale. Last one here. Good, bring it up, reverse lunge, back, up. Good, find your balance, step it back, pull it right back. Four more. Last two. Last one, hold it there. Take those hands down, come into a nice runner's lunge. Whatever foot is forward, I want you to take that same hand, float it up to the ceiling. Maybe take a little twist. If not, maybe you're staying right here. Good, coming into a plank or down to your knees, we're gonna switch sides. Opposite foot comes forward, press it up. Same hand, float it up, or keep it on down, stretching through that hip flexor. Good, stepping back into a plank. Maybe you're here, maybe you're on your knees. Good, go for four push-ups, down and up. Last one. Good, take a down dog or child's pose. Pipe the hips up, or press them back towards your heels. Stretch it out, team. Pedal those feet out if you're in that down dog. Good, carefully walk your hands back to your feet. If you're in a child's pose, bring yourself on up to standing. Good, bring those arms all the way up and around, big circle. Woo, take a breath. I'm gonna turn my heat off really quickly. Circle the other way. All right, take a nice deep breath. My husband likes to keep. I'm like 75, I'm dying. All right, inhale. Exhale. All right, we're ready. Let's do it, guys. First circuit here. Grab some water. Okay, so you have a single leg deadlift with the knee lift, and then we're gonna open. So you wanna go a little bit lighter on the waist for this. Okay, so option one, one foot goes down, one foot's gonna go back. You hinge from the hips. You bring it on down, try to keep your balance. As you come on up, you can open those arms out to the side, I'm gonna scoot out of the more room, out to the side, and you're gonna open, twist to one side, bring it back to center, repeat. Okay, so you're gonna bring it down, nice and slow, bring it on up, bring those arms out to the side, and then open twist. So you're gonna go over the opposite leg. So if your right leg is up, you're gonna twist open to that left side. We're staying on the same side the entire 50 seconds. Next round, we'll switch it up. If your balance is a little funky, especially for me right now, my balance is not great,
is the backyard. Again, feet can be here, okay? One knee in and down. And down.
Yes? All right, team. Let's do it. Three exercises. 50, 10, 4 rounds. It's about 12 minutes long. Okay, that's how we're working. You'll get a full recovery. You with me? All right, single leg deadlift. Set it up. We are on in 5, 4, 3, 2. 50 seconds starts right now, guys. Here we go. Single leg. Find your balance. Hinge from the hips. Bring it up. Balance. Open twist. Bring it back to center. If you do not feel comfortable with a twist, if you are pregnant and you don't feel comfortable with that open twist, totally fine. Just go for the single leg deadlift. You should feel that glute squeeze at the top. Use that breath. Inhale. Exhale. Maybe you stop, pause, then lift. 5 more seconds, guys. In 3, 2, 1. Good. Rest. 10 seconds. Slow and steady. Control the movement. Bicep curl. Team fly. Ready? Let's go. 50 seconds. We're on. Good, make sure you hinge from the hips here. Hips go back. Open it up. Good, so I'm sending my thumbs up on this one, guys. So my palms are out versus having my palms in like a normal reverse fly, okay? Exhale out on that hard part, right before. Right before that hard part, that's when you exhale. Good, stay with the team for 3, 2, 1, your weights go down. Good, bring it to the floor. Now remember, round one, you're just learning the movements. Round two, learning. You have 2 more rounds after that to crush it, okay? Take it down, here we go, reverse. You're up. Lift those knees into the chest, one at a time. Good, maybe you're in that full reverse plank here, staying strong, keeping the collarbone broad. You lift and lower. You want to add a little thrust here, you tap the hips down, you lift up, right leg. Left leg, tap the booty down, lift, squeeze. That's it, team. 5 more seconds, we're going into our second round. From the top in 3, 2, recover. Woo! All right, how are we doing that first round? You ready? 3 more. Grab your weights. Single leg deadlift, I want you to switch up the feet now. Ready? Here we go. Take it down. Bring it on up. Lift that knee, lift the arms. Open twist. Take it down, hinge from the hips. Soften that standing knee a little bit here. Way harder than it seems, right? Good, I want you to exhale as you open for that twist. Inhale back to center and repeat. That's it, team. Last 3, 2, and recover. 10 seconds. All right, bicep curl right into that T fly here. Ready, set, let's go. Curl it up. Good, maybe you build here a ladder. 2 and 2. 3 and 3. Try not to swing on that bicep curl. Good. Soften the knees a little bit. Core strong. Good. Stay with me, guys. You got 5 more seconds here. We're back down on the ground in 3, 2. Weights down. Bring it onto the floor. Here we go. Reverse plank. 50 seconds to work. Lift it up. Option just to stay with those knee drives in. Or tap the booty. Lift up. Squeeze the glutes. Use the hamstrings. Good. Collarbone broad. Keep those shoulders relaxed and away from the ears. Good. Think about keeping your belly pulling towards your spine. If you are pregnant, you want to keep that baby safe. Yes?
Go
but it's so important, guys, to continue working on the balance, right? So it's good to do deadlifts both feet down, but sometimes you want to challenge yourself, try to go for that single leg. You want to work every side, all directions, try to balance out right and left. Oh, I'm twisting the wrong way. Don't watch me. I'm twisting the wrong way on that leg. Keep that twist open. Keep that twist open. Good, you got 5 seconds. In 3, 2, 1. Rest. Maybe switch up those weights, maybe not. Bicep curl. Ready. Set. Let's go, guys. Bring it up. Core stay strong. We're using that core to stabilize. This is it, team. One exercise after this. We get a full recovery coming up. Stay with me.
Superman. Yes?
Okay, option if you're with me here. You can still keep the block. Come in.
into a hinge position. You're going to lift the arms up, place it down, place your hands on the block, lift one leg, lift the other leg. Come into a hinge position. Arms up, arms down. Shift your weight, lift, and lift. Okay? So that's where I'm going to work. And then number three, we're going for, if you can do it, single leg runner sit up. So I'll just demo this once. All right, you're going to come on up. Lift. So opposite arm and leg come up together. You go back down. You come back up. Lift. Opposite arm and leg. I will not be doing that one. I will be doing forearms down, legs up, toe taps, heel taps, one at a time. Okay? And if that's too much, you come back into that bird dog. Reach opposite arm and leg. So many options, guys. You do what feels best for you today. Okay, ready? Lock down. Set it up for that first leg. We got one reverse lunge, four knee drives in. Let's do it. Timer starting. In five, four, three, two, let's go. We're on. Starting up. Reverse lunge. Pop it off. Four drives. Stand up strong, lunge, pop off, pull it in. Good, so just try to find your balance here. Reverse lunge back, pop it off, pull. Good, so by having that block, you're getting a little more range of motion. But if that's too much, you just take it to the floor. All right? Coming up, 10 more seconds here, team. 10 more seconds. In five, four, three, two, on one, rest, 10. All right, keeping that block. Maybe you're on your stomach going for a full Superman. I'm on my knees, ready? Let's go, 50 seconds. Lift that block up right here. Place it down. Come forward, right leg, left leg. Using the core to lift yourself back up here, okay? Or you just stay in the hinge. Up. Good, hinge back. I'm gonna go just for that arm lift here. Shift forward, core strong. Squeeze the glutes. You're in that Superman, guys. I want you to think about lengthening. Don't worry about getting up so high. It's all about that length. In three, two, recover. Good rest. Woo. All right, runner sit-ups. Opposite arm and leg come up just like you're running or you're with me on your forearms. Get ready. Set. Let's go, let's go. 50 seconds. But if this is too much, guys, you do the opposite. Feet down, lift and lower. Okay? You can be there, or you can hold them up here in tabletop. But I want you to really keep that core strong, especially if you're pregnant here. Don't overdo it, so maybe right here is perfect. Keep breathing, keep breathing. Come on. You got it, 5 more seconds, guys. In 3, 2, 1. Good, rest. Carefully come on up. Move that block. We're taking it off to the other side. Reverse lunge. Let's go. 50 seconds starts now. That's it, team. You should be feeling that standing glute, that standing leg. On fire, 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1, rest.
come together if you're working there. Lift both legs together using those glutes. If you're here with me, lift. Lower. Shift the weight. Right leg lifts. Left leg lifts. Okay, take a second here. Use the core to get there. Notice how I'm slightly hinged from the hips here. Arms up, arms down. Good. Think about pulling that baby closer towards you if you're a pregnant guy. Last three, two, and one. Rest. Good. Breathe. Almost halfway. One more exercise. We're at 6 minutes out of 12. Take it onto your back or on your forearms. Ready. Set. Let's go. Let's go. Whew. I'm sweating. Good. If your tailbone here is kind of hurting, just double up the mat. Put something a little bit softer there if you need to, okay? Sometimes that gets a little uncomfortable. Full breath. Make sure those inhales are big. You're breathing into your sides, your back, your belly, your chest. You exhale. Keep those ribs from flaring. You don't want them to flare out. You guys know that, right? 5 seconds here, guys. Three, two, and one. Rest. Grab your block, place it down. We're going back to that first side, right where we started. Reverse lunge. Drive that knee 4 times. Ready? Set. Let's go. Keep it up, team, keep it up. But use that core here, stay strong, lifting up, lunge back, pop it off, pull. In 5, 4, 3, 2, recover. Woo! That glute's feeling it today. All right, belly in that Superman position, or take it to your knees. Here we go, 50 seconds, we are on. Lift those arms. Place it down, shift your weight into that tabletop. Lift, right? Left, otherwise both feet are lifting together, if you can. Good. As you lift those arms, I want you to feel the back muscles working here. Lats engaged. Ten more seconds like this. Good. Breathe. Three, two, one. Rest. Woo! All right. Second to last time, guys, working the core here, a little extra runner sit-ups or heel taps, toe taps. 50, 3, 2, 1, let's go. Good, always take time to adjust. If something doesn't feel right, if you're like, I know I'm supposed to be doing this in my core a lot, you're feeling it all in your lower back, you gotta adjust your position. Use that breath to re-engage, okay? You don't wanna feel it in the wrong spot. You don't wanna feel pain, okay? So just readjust, make it work, all right? Figure it out. I know it's hard. I can't come up to you and adjust you, but know where you're supposed to feel it. Tweak it a little. Maybe do a little less.
Rather have you do less and feel more control than go fast and kind of be out of control, okay? In 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1, rest. Beautiful job, team. Final round. We got 3 minutes. Pop it on up. Go ahead and grab that block if you're using it. Standing on it. Let's do it. Lunge. Pull. Good. The more you use the core on this one, the more that you stay strong through that standing leg, the easier it's going to be. Stand up tall before you lunge. Step back. Drop low. Careful of that front knee. You want to keep it in line with your ankle. Slightly in front is okay, but it should not be shifting way over your toes. Give me 3, 2, and 1. Rest. Breathe. All right. Bring it down. Whew, almost there, guys. Back extension, Superman. We're right here with me. In 3, 2, 1, let's go. Sorry, I'm not really centered on my mat here. All right, hinge. Now remember the goal of this class, guys, is to build strength throughout the body, focusing on that backside. Mostly low impact movements, but you're feeling it. Your heart rate should come up because we move fast. All right, so we're working high intensity here because we're really just resting for those 10 seconds where we transition. Functional movements, movements that help us in our everyday lives. Last 3, 2, and 1, recover. This is it, final round of your toe taps or runner sit-ups. You're getting a full recovery after this, guys, in 3, 2, last minute. Breathe. You can do it. But if you're here with me and you're feeling it more in your hip flexors, your core is probably not doing the work it needs to be doing, okay? So maybe you start here and you just lift. And I want you to think about exhale, use the core, draw the belly in, knit the ribs together. Inhale, exhale, lift, okay? Hip flexors should be released here. You don't want them to be tightening up. Good full recovery coming up, guys, in 5, in 3, 2, and rest. Breathe it out. Breathe it out, guys. Awesome job. Recover. All right. Here we go. Here we go. Final circuit. Final circuit, guys. I'm going to go ahead and grab a little bit of a heavier set of weights here. But you do it, feels good. We have a bicep curl coming into a sumo stance. Okay, so for this one, you want your toes out a little bit. You want your knees to be tracking over that second toe as you come down. You're going to squat down into a sumo. Bring it on up. Curl. Sumo. Drop. Curl. Okay, so you're going to continue with the legs. Sumo. Sumo. The arms are just going to be hanging, and then they're going to curl. Okay, so one more set of those bicep curls. Then we're coming into a renegade row. So if you feel comfortable here, you're gonna be in a full plank. One weight in each hand, you're pressed up. Okay, renegade row, you're gonna row here. Bring it down, open into a side plank. That arm can come up and overhead. You can draw the knee into the elbow, take it back, and reset. Okay, for me, and if you're pregnant, you don't wanna put too much weight there, so you're just on your knees. Renegade row, up, tap down. You're going to open by shifting that knee. Come up here. Same exact thing. Knee to elbow. Reset. Bring it back down. Okay, so there's a lot going on in this movement. Take your time. You can separate the movement out. One row. Bring it down.
down, then open, then elbow to knee, reset. It doesn't need to be like a very fluid motion, okay? You're gonna alternate the entire time. Right arm, open, left arm, open. Yes, okay, and then finally, our last exercise is gonna be inner thigh leg lifts. And this is gonna engage the core, but you're gonna really get that inner thigh. So your back leg is gonna be kickstand, okay? This front leg is gonna be toes pointed out forward, forearm here, you're gonna lift and lower that straight leg. Now, I'm saying it's core too, because you gotta engage those obliques. You don't wanna just slump down like this and hang out. So really lifting up through the side body and then connecting to that midline inner thigh. Okay, so we'll do one side, 25 seconds. We'll do the other side, 25 seconds. Yes? Woo! All right, team, let's do it. Final 12 minutes, we're gonna cool it down. You are done for the day. Stay with me, grab a sip of water, take a deep breath. Yell, shout, whatever you need to do. Get yourself ready, amped up. All right, we're starting off with those sumos. In three. In two, on one, let's go. 50 seconds, team, to work it out. Good, you can slow this down if you're going a little bit heavier. Otherwise, just keep a nice tempo there. So good, team, you got this. You got this, this is your time here. Stay with me. Good, keep those hips open here to keep it nice and wide from the hip. 5 seconds. In three, two, on one, recover. Bring it on down, we're going ready, game row. On the knees, we're in a full plank, ready, set. Let's go, let's go. Row, open it up, side plank, adjust, pull. Reset, bring it back down. Other side. Center that knee, open it up. Good, so you do have to take a second to adjust those knees. Adjust the feet. Like I said, it's not a fluid motion. Bring it back down. As you row, I want you to think about those back muscles doing some work. Elbow goes up towards the ceiling. Good, last three, two, and recover, guys. Inner thigh leg lift. Take it down to one side. Forearm down, lift up through the side body, kickstand that leg. Good, lift it up, here we go. Good, you can slightly rotate, so you don't have to be perfectly forward on this. Slightly rotate it. Hips slightly up the ceiling. Good, you know what, let's stay on this one leg. We'll switch every round, okay? Easier transition. Reach through the heel. Use the core, stay strong. 10 seconds. Woo! Are you feeling that? 3, 2, 1, rest. Good, take a little stretch if you need it, up and over. All right, sumos. Pop it up. Let's go, 50 seconds, team, we're on. Round two. Good, you want to think about dropping that tailbone down. Right here, drop it down as you go for that sumo. We're not sticking down, breathe out like this, no twerking. All right, drop it down, chest comes up.
Keep those knees pressing back from the hips.
Thank you.
Try to really reach through that leg. The more you reach, the more you're going to feel that inner thigh. Really engage those hip adductors. Last time on this side, guys. Final 5 seconds. And recover. Stretch. Good. All right. Here we go. Sumos. Ready? Set. Let's go. Drop the loop.
Lengthening before you bend.
lifting before you bend, switch. Good, carefully bring it onto your hands and knees. Moving through a cat-cow here. Maybe going for that full extension, lifting the head. Otherwise, just letting the belly relax. And then as you exhale, you draw the belly in, round the spine, tuck the chin to the chest, press those hands into the mat. Good, coming back to center. Curling those toes under, piping the hips up, come into your down dog. Now, if you're not too flexible, guys, bend the knees a little here, okay? It's better to bend the knees than to be kind of in this awkward position, uncomfortable position. So just a little bend is perfectly okay. Good, center that right foot, send that left leg up. Bending the knees, let the hip open. Bring it on down, switch. Good, carefully walk your hands back towards your feet. Feet can be hip distance or a little wider. Go ahead and bend down here. And then extend, hips go back up. Two more like that. On this last one, you let that head hang heavy. Head hang heavy. Grab onto opposite elbow, rock it side to side. When you're ready, slowly roll it on up. Take your time getting there. Good, roll the shoulders. All the way up, back, and down. And then reverse it. Good, send one arm straight out. Carefully press back on those fingertips, thumb out to the side. And switch. Good, interlace the hands here. I like to press my palms out and just rounding a little bit through the upper back here. So you're gonna feel those shoulder blades open up. Then bringing those arms up, you can take a little extension if that feels okay. Release all the way here. Shake the arms and legs out. Remember, guys, always stretch, foam roll more if you need to. Whatever feels tight, send a little bit of that breath into it. I'm going to take one more stretch like this. I'm going to take those feet wide. Turn the toes out. So I'm going right toes out. Other foot stays parallel. All right, and we're just going to stretch, lean into it a little bit here. Bending that leg. Good. Bring it back up here one more time. Good, bring it on up, parallel the feet, flip the other toes out, same thing, I'm going to bend that knee, just take a little stretch. Good, lift up, inhale, exhale. Good, bring it on up. Final breath here, guys, take a nice big inhale, reach those arms up, you did it, you made it. You should be so proud of yourself, bring those hands to prayer. Big exhale out the mouth. And you are done. So good, guys. Any questions, you can always reach out to me. You know that. Hopefully you feel energized, alive. You know, maybe you're a little bit sore, a little bit tired, but you should feel energized. That's the goal of the workout. You should feel alive, awake, ready to go for the rest of the day and week. All right? So I will see you guys next time. Have an awesome day. Good job today.